A very special guest on our show, Dr. Srinivas, who is an engineer, and he was the deputy head of the aerospace engineering division in the University of Sydney, and also above all, he's a writer. Dr. Srinivas, welcome to Aussie Indian.
Thank you.
Maybe we can start off by asking you about your own background,
mm-hmm.
where you were educated and how you ended up at the University of Sydney.
I did my BE from the College of Engineering in 1968 in Bangalore.
Mm-hmm.
Then I started at the Indian Institute of Science, where I did a master's in what was called the heat power engineering.
Yeah, that's what I remember.
And then following that, I did a PhD in an emerging field which was called computational fluid dynamics.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So after that, I worked at the National Aerospace Lab in India for about 4 years. Then I got an invitation from the University of Sydney to be a research fellow here. So accepting that, I came over to Australia in 1981.
Okay.
So from 1981 till I retired, I have been associated with the University of Sydney and of the very same department, the Department of Mechanical Engineering, School of Aerospace, and other things.
And of course, we are here to discuss your writing capabilities. How did your writing career start, and is this a passion?
Yeah, it is a passion, and in fact, to tell you the truth, my writing started when I was in high school.
Oh, okay.
I used to write in English, Kannada, run the class magazine, and so many things.
Mm-hmm.
So slowly that has developed from those days, and in 1970, mid-70s and all that, I used to write to the newspapers in India, and I have given several talks over All India Radio Bangalore,
right,
about science and non-science topics.
And of course, you have written books, engineering books. If you can tell us what kind of work, what books you have written?
So one of the books I have written is this, which is a textbook.
Mm-hmm.
It's about propulsion,
right?
Which is a subject which we teach,
right,
in the third year.
Mm-hmm.
So I have written a book on aerodynamics,
right?
Which I haven't brought right now.
Mm-hmm.
And then I also wrote a book on computational fluid dynamics, which was published by the Springer. That was about 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And then in 2002, I was elected to be the chairman of International Committee on International Computational Fluid Dynamics Conference.
Mm-hmm.
I was the chairman of that.
Right.
That conference took place in Sydney.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the proceedings, and I'm one of the editors of this.
Computational Fluid Dynamics.
Fantastic. So these are some of my technical writings.
Now let's come to the non-technical writing. You have obviously, as you said, you developed that passion,
yes,
and you,
sir,
have been trying to write these non-technical books. When you started this, was there any particular subject you were interested in?
No, it all started with stories actually. I used to write short stories in Kannada and also English. And they have been published maybe in Indian Link or maybe in Indian Down Under.
Yes.
And also Kannada ones have been published in the internet journals like that's Kannada.com or Kenda Sampige. And one or two have been published in the daily newspapers of India, Kannada newspapers. And then I have written about science, many things on science. So they have also been published by all these journals.
Mm-hmm.
And I have been writing from time to time on Einstein from 1979, actually.
Okay.
1979 was his birth centenary.
Right. So you got that book here, haven't you?
Yeah. One of the Kannada books I have written about Einstein is here.
There you go. Yes, that's on Einstein. And
then the one more on Einstein, enlarged one,
mm-hmm,
is coming up, is getting published in Bangalore next year.
Right.
That's in English and about 200 to 250 pages.
Mm. Well, let's come to the most recent book,
yeah,
that you have released. And this is about one of the very famous mathematicians of India. If you can tell us his background and how you took interest in writing a book.
So this is about Srinivasa Ramanujan, one of the greatest mathematicians in the world, and probably the greatest that India may have given the world. And how I got into this is really interesting. When in London I bought a book, Oxford Writings on Science, and in that there was a very interesting article by a guy called C.P. Snow. And C.P. Snow writes about the day when Professor Hardy in Cambridge received a letter from Ramanujan.
Right.
And whatever the sequence of events that took place on that day he has written. And it was so fascinating and it attracted me all of a sudden. And I wrote it, and I also wrote it in Kannada and sent it to a magazine which was later published. But at about the same time, we were having lunch in our department. The head of school, his name is Steve Armfield, and he was talking to me. He said, did Ramanujan die because he cooked rasam in a vessel which had lost all its polish? Then I said, who told you all this? Then he said, there is a novel called The Indian Clerk. There he claims that that's the cause of death for Ramanujan. I said, oh, I don't know about it. I felt a bit sorry and ashamed about it. Then the next day he gave me the book and asked me to read it. So I read that and it was so fascinating, Ramanujan, the hardship and all that. And then I remember somewhere in our house there was a book called The Man Who Knew Infinity that has been laying in our house for more than 20, 25 years, which I had not opened. So immediately I located the book and started reading it, and it was absolutely fascinating, the life of Ramanujan.
Well, mind-boggling, that's the word, I think. But if you, for our viewers, if you can encapsulate some of the mathematical genius of Ramanujan, just what he did, some examples of that. Of course, you mentioned infinity. Apart from that, what else did Ramanujan bring to mathematics?
For example, he developed, in fact, this he did as he was a school student, a series expansion for pi.
Okay.
How to calculate pi as accurately as we want. And during those days, of course, people could hand calculate it to about 100 or 200 places. And using those formulas, only last year, people in Japan have calculated pi up to, I think, a trillionth place.
Right.
Using 70 hours of computation, it has been calculated up to trillion places. That's using his formulas. And then the other thing he developed was, he is known for is what is called the partition. So, for example, in how many ways can you express 4? You can write it as 4, 1 plus 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 plus 2, or 2 plus 2, etc. So that means 4 has about 4 or 5 partitions. And the challenge he put upon himself was, given a number, how to calculate the partitions. So that is said to be the greatest contribution of Ramanujan, namely partition. Continued fraction is the other one. So that is explained in the book also.
Okay, if any of our viewers who are looking at this program want to know more about Ramanujan and also get hold of more information on the work he has done, is there a website they can visit or a telephone number, or are you happy to talk to the people who are interested?
Of course, there are numerous websites which are of help. And if anybody would like to contact me, I'll be very happy to help him. My number is 0402-375-275.
There you go. Dr. Srinivas has offered to talk to you if you are interested in knowing more about Ramanujan, or for that matter, any of his other books as well.
Of course.
And that number is at the bottom of the screen. Dr. Srinivas, thanks very much for finding time to come and talk to us.
Oh, pleasure.
Thank you.